Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. Now, as we get into bonding of organic molecules, we're going to involve orbitals on carbons and nitrogens and oxygens, and we're going to talk about hybrid orbitals. So we need to be able to describe what these orbitals look like so we can draw the orbital pictures and see how they combine with other orbitals. Now, so let's pick a hybridization and let's pick a simple one. So I have the orbitals on a second row element. We'll just say it's carbon. And we'll do sp hybridization. So sp hybridization, we're going to take the s and p orbital. We are going to get two new orbitals. And plus we're going to have our two leftover p orbitals. So four atomic orbitals go into our hybrid scheme. And we get four new atomic orbitals. They're still on carbon coming out. So what do these things look like? Well, we're combining two orbitals. We're combining the S and P. Mathematically, we can add them or we can subtract them. And we have, in this second column, we're going to describe that a little bit more. So S plus P. This is what our S orbital looks like. Two, let's go back to the left. We haven't talked about P orbitals very much, or at least drawn them. P orbitals kind of look like this. People call them a dumbbell. I don't think that looks anything like a dumbbell, but that's what people say. As it turns out, the dumbbell, one side has a positive sign and the other side is negative. There is a node in the middle of our p orbital. So as we go back to the right, to the middle column, so superimposed on this s orbital, on this carbon, there is also a p orbital. And they're on the same atom, so we're going to draw them on the same atom. One side is shaded positive, the other is not. So when these combine together, we get constructive interference on this side and destructive interference, where they overlap on the other side, the positive and negative. And what we get out is a new atomic orbital. It's kind of bigger on one side and smaller on the other. And this is our new SP hybrid orbital. This is our wave function. So we created a new one. Now we combine two orbitals. We have to get two orbitals out. Where's our second orbital? Our second orbital comes from subtracting these two orbitals. Now again, I think subtraction is kind of a weird idea, but what we're going to do is we're going to add the negative of our p orbital. What is this going to look like? Okay, well, let's draw the same s orbital. And it's still positive. Now we're going to mix it to the with the negative of our p orbital. Draw our p orbital. The negative is simply just going to flip the sign. So now the left-hand side will be positive, and the right-hand side is negative. So now we get constructive interference over on the left, destructive on the right, and our new orbital, sp hybrid, looks kind of like this. This is our second sp hybrid. This is the wave function of it. Now, if you notice, these two new orbitals kind of point in opposite directions. And that's exactly what we saw with sp hybridization. Sp hybridization, the expected bond angle will be 180 degrees. Why is it 180? It's because these orbitals point in the opposite direction. One of them points to the left-hand side and the other to the right-hand side. And if you want to get really nitpicky about it, if one side or the other, it's not any side. You know, in this case, we've kind of shown as if it's the y-axis. One points to the positive end of the y-axis, one points to the negative end of the y-axis, so we get this bond angle of 180. Okay, so what other hybrids? So we've only shown sp. We know there's also sp2, there's also sp3. When we talk about hybrids, oftentimes people talk about percent p character. And in sp hybridization, since half the orbitals are p, we say that's 50% p character. For sp2, it's more like 67%. And for sp3, it's three parts p, one part s, it's 75%. I'm going to try to draw these orbitals differently. But what we see is sp hybridization, as we get more and more p character, these orbitals, they kind of get longer and thinner. So higher p character, and these are exaggerated, but you tend to get longer orbitals. In practice, when we draw them, they're all going to look like this. And you're not going to be able to visually really tell, but that's okay. We just want the general shape when we mix them. So this is the appearance of our hybrid orbitals. And we're going to now mix these with other orbitals, maybe s orbitals or other hybrid orbitals, and we're going to see how they combine together to make new bonding orbitals.